Come on. Save the world, but can't jump over a fence? Bonjour. Ah, if it isn't Iggy, how went the meeting with the Sylphs? Here you go. I did my job. The Sylph folk have long been friends of Gridania. The mere thought of being at war with them pained the elder Seedseer to no end. But owing to your efforts, she will be able to rest easier, being the benevolent soul that she is. My lady will surely try to find a way to reverse the something. Oh, they want me to go back to the Sands? Why are there so many people around here? What's happening? Odin? What's Odin? Oh my god. Oh my god. I am not in the right spot. What is happening? I cannot move. I don't know where I am. Did I just die? I don't know if I'm standing in the right area. Am I supposed to be standing in that area? I'm so scared. Wait, no. I'm dead. How do you fucking escape something like this? Oh my god. I'm like, yeah, it's just Odin. Oh my god. I'm dead again. No, 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 no. Jesus. I'm dead. It just one-shots me every single time. Okay. That was beautiful. Well, if this isn't my favorite adventure, welcome back, Iggy. Lady Minfilia awaits. Okay. Let's go. Oh, what's that? I'm given to understand that the matter of Ramu has finally been resolved. I feel resolved bespeaks a permanence we cannot rightly claim, yet I am well satisfied that the Lord of Lavine will not trouble us in the foreseeable future. He said your satisfaction is certain enough for me. How fares the investigation? Well enough. Thancred is sparing no effort. There are many and one, just as you suspected. Their purpose, however, eludes us still. I see. Ugh, I have been meaning to ask, but is Elise quite well? I feel as if I have secretly seen her in recent days. Oh, you haven't, and nor have I. Alas, Elise... How the fuck do I... Elisa? Elise? But you may be assured that our destination remains the same? Elise. Oh, okay. And on that note, I take my leave of you. I trust the Baldasian report will serve you well. I take it we can proceed as discussed. Why do you ask? You scarce need my permission to act. Yes, babe, walk. Let me just check him out. It's good to see you again, Iggy. I have been looking forward to congratulating you on your triumph in the Twelves Wood. Owing to your effort, conflict has been averted. Truly, you have done the signs proud. With that, we can strike Ramu from the least. So who's next? The Shahagin? The Leviathan? The Lord of the Horl has not answered his minions' call of late, nor is he expected to do so in the near future. While the Shahagin remain as aggressive as ever, they lack the quantity of crystal required to call for their god. As with the Sylphs, we can leave them to their own devices, for a time, at least. For a time, bears repeating, we can ill afford to fall complacent. It is Ishtola says, unless we know the minds of the beast tribes, we cannot predict with any certainty when next a primal will return to plague the land. Any word on Titan? The maelstrom keeps the kobolds under constant observation. We shall hear from them ere long. You may depend on it. Indeed. So then, of all the known primals that have been active in recent times, we are left with... Gridania! Wait, I mean Garuda, who is the primal of the Isal, who live near Gridania. Yes, that's what I meant. So many moms to cover. Would that there were a more efficient way to conduct our surveys? Were he still with us, we should not long have wanted for a more practical solution. She's not wrong there. When in the world are you, chief? Oh, there's a chief. But one sure step at a time. Henceforth, the Order of the Twin Adder will handle all matters pertaining to the Sylphs under the sage guidance of the Seedseers. I bid you all enjoy a moment's respite. You have earned it. Is there something else, Iggy? Beg pardon? A man named Lahabrea, sporing a red mask and robed in black, 12 preserve. Prior to the calamity, the science took great pains to remain hidden. Why would they choose to cast off their veil of secrecy now? Gods, this bodes ill. We must take advantage of the present lull in primal hostilities and investigate the Lahabrea. Learn all we can of him and his designs. I dread... Tataru is screaming. Tataru! Oh? A sylph in Thanalon? At long last, this one finds walking one Ygritte. Oh, it's Naraxia. This one is most dependable of these ones. I sent my elder one Phryxio to help walking ones. This one is called Naraxia. This one comes as a friend. Let these ones be friends. Pleasure to meet you, Naraxia. Is she joining us? Yes, Tataru is ready to express her fright as she is to express everything else. Not all of us are forged of the same steel as you, I'm afraid. But it takes all kinds to make family, and it pleases me to no end to see ours continue to grow. One by one, the people of Eorzea are beginning to unite, Iggy, drawn to the hope that shines within you. Yet a darkness threatens to engulf this light. Never have I doubted the Ascian's presence. But they have grown so brazen as to carry out their work in plain sight fills me with a sense of deep foreboding. I'm afraid there is no rest for the worry. Okay, what do you want me to do? Just send me there. Earlier I sent word to each grand company to solicit cooperation. The Immortal Flames responded to the effect that they have information on potential sightseeing. But whatever you do, never forget that we are dealing with the unknown. You cannot take too many precautions. Be safe, Iggy. I kind of found myself in, because, like, I had no idea that that was a thing. And then my lovely Final Fantasy friends who got me into this game told me all about, like, there's, like, the ERP, is that what it's called? But there's the, there's a whole thing for it. Like, a whole hashtag for, like, not safe for work, art, and, like, accounts on Twitter. Like, people actually make accounts for their own characters. I clicked on the tag because I was like, okay, art! Bro! My god! That was insane. And there, I've seen Ruben in all of his glory. Don't advertise it. What do you mean, don't advertise it? They made an entire advertisement in Texas. They have an entire billboard for that. Oh. Nice stash, daddy. What's up? Gondobald. Not very bald. Who are you? State your business and be quick about it. Oh, he was one of those. Looking for a masked villain, you say? And why should we help you? Pray? I like how he has like a titty window. Like, yes, I'm a warrior, but the most like dangerous part that's supposed to be protected is like open. We struggle enough without having to answer the whim of every outsider. You're not welcome here. Be gone. Oh, you're so mean. Final Fantasy community is equal parts cursed and wholesome. I think that was probably the funniest thing for me, because like when I was talking about it, I was talking about how wholesome it is and how much fun I'm having in this game and how the community is so sweet. And like, now everyone's just like, you know, once you, like, it's very inclusive. And then y'all told me about ERP and I was like, okay, look, in my days, we had stuff, you know, like, I'm not gonna say anything about that. But the lengths that this went into? Goodness! Well met, adventurer, I'm Gizelbert, head of the security here at Lil Amigo. I heard tell that you had business with Gundobald. Knowing this bristly old bear, don't doubt he told you to bugger off. Okay, what am I supposed to do? Deliver cups of tea to the lookout. Me saving the world, nah. Just, you know, giving tea to people. Many thanks, my dear. Oh, it's that room that I haven't been to before. Hair hurt. Johnny Bravo! Hey, little mama. It is an Ygritte Denethor, the sign's rising star. Is there aught I can do for you? Oh my god, he knows me. Oh my god. He knows who I am. Hi. You wish to win the trust of the people of Little Al Amigo? That is a daunting task, my friend, even for our own countryman. I would like nothing more than to help, but I'm afraid my name no longer carries weight with that lot. I used to be a member of the Al Amigo Resistance, you see, but I left in favor of joining the Scions. Though my alliance may have shifted, my purpose remains ever the same.
The liberation of Al Amigo.
Para por qué? Por qué es Al Amigo? Habert sent you? Ugh, a worthless horse son! He abandoned his comrades, his woman, and now he has the gall to ask me for a favor? Simply incredible. I realized that Harbert was only doing what he felt was right. He's a good man, and if he trusts you, then that's all I need to know. You see that bloke there? That's Murfred, a captain of the Resistance. I hope he can give you what you need. Now hold on a second. This game is so fun. I'm having so much fun with all the plot that is going on here. The raids are fantastic. I'm Murfred, a proud man of the Al Amigan Resistance. Hi. Oh my god, there's more! Captain! It's Galleon, sir. His wound's gone and festered. And he's burning up. I don't think he's got much time. Oh no, I'm sure that he has a dying wish that I can take care of. God damn it! I asked the villagers for aid! Got on my knees and begged! Oh my god, he got on his knees and begged? Oh wait, that changes things. If Galleon dies, his blood is on their hands. I mean, if you want to get on your knees and beg, I can help you. The quarry mill cravens would turn a blind eye to our plight, but they might listen to Albreda. I fear my anger will prevent me from rightly convincing anyone at the moment. I realize we scarce know each other, but this is a matter of life and death. Please, adventurer, go to her and try. You're so cute when you're begging. Okay, I guess they're gonna help me out. Okay, Albreda, I'm talking to you again. One of Mefred's in bad shape, you say? I'm sorry, but there's not I can do. I want to help, truly I do. They're my countrymen, after all. That means going against the elemental will. Huh? I've been Quarrymill long enough to know how right terrible the beings can be. I couldn't forgive myself if everyone gets banished because of me. That's how it's been then. bloody hair might as well kill Galleon herself. Spit on the elementals and spit on their bloody will. Cannot wait until the resistance is free of the spirits. Helping Horn, you called? I led my men to Quirrymill, hoping to find refuge. Instead, we found indifference. The cold-blooded bastards here want us out, and I can't oblige them soon enough. The problem is, some of mine aren't fit to travel. Hell's Gallon can even stand. As you well I know, the people of the accursed hamlet won't help us, so I've no choice but to turn to you, adventurer. I'll help you, baby. I'll do anything you want.
Anything for you, babe! Don't worry about it. I'll take care of you. I'll take good care of you. On my way to get digged by a good Highlander!
We're going back to my boy. Where's my boyfriend?
Where's my Highlander?
There he is. Here's your meat, daddy. Ah, you're back. Tell me you've got 4 horns. Yes, you got all the horns you want.
Couple of horns from a horny girl.
You're a godsend, adventurer. Praise Ralgar. There's at least one woman in this place who gives a damn. Now we just need to find a way to prepare them. You wouldn't happen to know a man named Buskaran, would you? Some comrades of mine told me about him once. They said he never turns away folk in need, no matter where they're from. Seeing as he runs a tavern, he's like to have the fools to make the medicine. I'd be grateful if you could take the horns over to him. Uh-huh. Hi, Besk. Been here before. And I'm talking to Fairmond. It is well to see you return. Have you the medicine for our brother? Yes. There you go. God bless you, adventurer. I'll see that Galleon receives treatment at once. Hopefully this will allow the captain to rest easier. It has been a terrible burden on him, trying to keep every man alive. You've done us a great kindness, friend.
Aww.
He ain't heavy. This is just getting better. Adventurer, Galleon has gone missing. He's nowhere to be found. He shouldn't be walking about. Not with those wounds. If he doesn't get the proper medicine at rest, his condition is gonna get worse. Albretta. Finally. It's about time you came asking about Galleon. I watched him leave Cornmeal some time ago, and he left me this sealed letter before he went off. Made me swear not to open it until someone came asking. My brothers, I cannot bear to be burdened any longer. That is why I must leave you. Aww. Now we need to go find him before he dies. Oh my god, he's all so hot. Why are all of them so hot? Don't worry, daddy. I'll take care of it. Like, this is just a fucking dream come true, right? Just an entire fucking team of super hot dudes. Like, all about friendships and brotherhood. Here you go. I took care of it. Galleon! Captain, but why? You should all be on your way. Who do you take us for? We're Alamegans, and Alamegans never forsake one another. Hardships be damned. Remember the oath we swore, goddammit? The oath to reclaim our homeland. We'll set foot on Alamegan soil again, together, or not at all. Do you understand me? Okay, now I kind of ship them. God damn it. Ugh. Good. Let us return to our brothers. Oh, and don't even think that you'll get off lightly. As soon as you're healed, I'll give you such a thorough thrashing, you'll wish we didn't find you. Can I get a thorough thrashing? What does a bitch gotta do to get a thorough thrashing? Oh my god, he's crying! Stop! You're so cute! I can't thank you enough for saving Galleon. I will see you back at Quirrymill. Like, why are y'all half naked though? Like, is that necessary? Oh lord. Mefred. Hi. Galen's expected to make a full recovery. We'll linger here till he's strong enough to take to the road again. As much as I mislike this place, beggars can be choosers. Now that things are relatively settled, I seem to recall that you wanted something from me. You've proven a true friend to my people. Ask of me anything, and it's yours! So long as it's mine to give! Stop! Ah, the jokes are just writing themselves! The way that he looks at me, I'm so tiny! The cooperation of the people of Little Alamigo? That's all? No! Far be it for me to question your desires, of course. No! Please question my desires! My desires are very questionable! Very well, I will provide you with a letter to show to Gundebald. The old bear was my mentor when I first joined the resistance! Not the old bear! Stop! Wait! I mean, it would make sense that none of them are straight. He's intimidating to those who don't know him, but he takes care of his own. Oh, does he really? I've no doubt that he will do all in his power to aid you. No, please look at me. Notice me. Notice me! Why do I have to always become like a hot drooling mess every time I see like a 2D mommy or a 2D daddy, like... So ashamed of myself. Why are you so big? I can't believe that he's called Bear. Like, you are huge. Why have you returned? You are not welcome here. I thought I made that clear. He's so mean. Okay, then I'm gonna give him the letter. You spoke to Mefred? It has been so long since I last heard from him. I had fear him's dead. 12 be praised. Whoever you are, Mefred sees you as a friend, and any friend of Mefred is a friend of mine. I know of his masked stranger you seek, and will tell you what I can. Yas! An outsider resembling your masked stranger has reportedly been appearing near Little Alamigo of late. What's more, it seems that some of our young bloods are meeting him in secret. No doubt you'll want to question them about their trysts, but they are not like to yield the information readily to an outsider. If you tell them I sent you, though, they may well feel obliged to talk. Oh, damn, you're hot. Gumball sent you? Listen, I told them it was a bad idea, all that tribe about believing the masked man. You don't know anything about this? Why didn't you say so to start with? You can't throw the old bear's name around like that and expect me to think I'm in for it. A masked man? No idea what you're talking about. And done nothing wrong, so leave me be. I'm afraid I can't. Like, I could never be in, like, an MMO IRL. Like, if I ended up in an isekai, I'm done for. I'd fall in love with, like, every single new man or woman I'd meet. So they're literally cavemen. It's like a bunch of Ooga Booga cavemen. Hi, bear. Nah. I will never get over this. I'll just never get over this. I'm obsessed. I ship myself with literally every single character I speak to. That is most troubling. Whatever the young ones are scheming, it can lead to no good. There's an anger inside them. I can see it in their eyes. I ought to know for it once burned within me as well. 2 decades ago, the same anger drove me and my brothers to rise against the despot who ruled Alamigo. Not would do, but to oppose him and usher in a revolution. Well, we got our revolution all right, but it cost us our freedom. Blinded by our hate, we didn't realize that we had been dancing to the Empire's tune. By the time we did, it was too late. Alamigo had fallen. There are times when a man must be patient. Now it's such a time. Though the young ones know this not, unless we intervene, they are like to commit great folly. They aren't cavemen per se. Their entire nation was invaded by the Garland Empire, and these are the few refugees that escaped, went to Ulda, and were turned away from there as well, which is why they are so poor and angry. Hi, Wild Red. Oh my god. Titty windows and little loincloths. Thank you for coming, friend. Just no ordinary outsider who can gain the trust of an older bear. That's why I wanted to meet you, to discuss something in private. Tell me, why are you snooping about? Did the Empire send you? Or someone else? Curl gut your tongue? No matter. Whoever it is you work for, your meddling ends here. Get her! Oh no. Oh no. Don't attack me. Oh no, what am I gonna do? Now what? You're stronger than you look. Yeah, I know. This changes nothing. Threaten us, beat us bloody all you like, but nothing short of death can make us give up our fight. Women in history didn't use war and fight to get shit out of men. We're going to obtain the power to bring down the Empire. And with it, we'll reclaim our homeland. While we'd mentioned obtaining the power to bring down the Empire, of what power could be speaking? I can't. Bertiliana! God preserve, what happened? I was out foraging when the corpse brigade came. They took me to their hideout and they... No! Wait, what the fuck? The whole while they laughed at me? They said that I suffer because I cling onto hope? Is it wrong to dream of home? It is wrong to call ourselves Alamigans? Do not heed such poisonous notions, child. Our dreams are what sustains us. Be strong, I swear to you. Those villains will answer for their crimes in due time. But tell me, does anyone else know of this? Wild Red, he saw me outside. He was so angry. Our mass sent to Berlatina. In the meantime, I need you to find out what the young ones make of this. I fear that they may do something rash. Whose cock am I ripping off? What those animals did to Berlatina is unforgivable, and to think they look down on us. Well, I'll suffer this humiliation no more. I'm with Wild Red to the bitter end. I'm not afraid of a few lizards. My Lord of Destruction, we implore you, lend us your strength and put an end to the suffering of your people. Were to interfere again? Well, you're too late. Our plan is already in motion. Once we have the crystals, our enemies will pay for their crimes. Like, this became dark very quickly. Gone? The whole lot of them? Then it has feared. They mean to take matters in their own hands. A hunting knife, a map of Zonrock. Wait, you said the Wild Red spoke of crystals, did you not? They couldn't possibly mean to. By the gods. The young fools are untrained and unblooded all. They have no notion of how dangerous the Amalja are. They'll be butchered before they get within 100 yams of crystals. Oh, fuck. Wild Red, did no others survive? This is all wrong. Getting the crystals was supposed to be the best start. But we're going to reclaim our homeland, Lore. Pull yourself together, lad. We're going to make an offering of crystals to Ralgar, to summon him, just like he the Mask One taught us. We plotted to sneak into Zonrock and make off with the lizard men's cash. But they caught us, and so many dead. Heathens, you shall pay for your crimes with your souls. I regret our young ones' transgressions, but a soul is too high a price of youthful folly. For all their failings, they're the hope of Alamigan people. This hope I will guard with my life. Shit. Your skill at arms is impressive, adventurer. Our wayward youths could learn much more of a woman like you. The battle is won, but it wouldn't be unwise to linger here. Let us return to Little Alamigo. Wait, we've come all this way. We have to get the crystals. They're right there, ripe for the picking. Have you learned nothing, Wyrell? Did you not see those tempered warriors? Such is the fate of those who are touched by a god. Is that what you desire for yourself and your friends? What? No! One said anything about... The Masked Man told us we could defeat the Empire if we summoned Ralgar. He swore. Enough. I will fear the rest of this sorry tale back in the Little Alamigo. I dare say Ygri will wish to hear it as well. Using youth. No more lies, Wellward. Tell us everything. I was outside with the others when he appeared, the masked stranger. He told us about summoning Ralgar, about using crystals, and then just vanish. We never saw him again. I wanted so desperately to believe that we could raise ourselves from this squalor and that I never stopped to question his motives. But I should have known. There is no solution, nothing we can do to change our lot. Our people are doomed to live and die like beasts. Listen to me, Wildred. Our home may be lost to us, but it takes more than stones and mortar to define who we are. No matter where we may be, Alamigo lives on within us. It is for you to decide what to make of this legacy, but whatever you choose to do with your life, never forget that you owe it to this adventure, an outsider. Thank you for saving me, and sorry I tried to kill you.